Hi, I'm Katie Bunschoten, the president and founder of Certum Solutions here in Monroe, North Carolina. And as a QuickBooks solution provider practice, we are going to go over the newest updates for QuickBooks Online Advanced. If any of these updates also apply to QuickBooks Online Plus or Essentials, I'll make sure to point that out while we're going through it. But for today, we are in our QuickBooks Online Advanced demo. Okay, before I get started, you know what I'm going to say. I say it every time. If you like this video, can you please like it down below? Because I go off of the likes to decide what we're going to record next. If you like the content I have to provide and the education we're providing, and hopefully a little bit of entertainment too, make sure that you subscribe to our actual channel. And that way, when new stuff comes out, you're going to be the first to know. With all that being said, my little spiel being out of the way, let's go ahead and get started, okay? The first thing that we're going to go over are the custom reports functions. They have a couple new features that are in QuickBooks Online Advanced now. If you don't see any of this, just hold tight. I know that they're going to be rolling it out to you. What QuickBooks sometimes does is they roll some of these features out to current customer or to brand new customers, and then they roll it out to the rest of us in stages. Okay, so we're going to go over how to build some new features with QuickBooks Online Advanced custom reporting. And that's where I am here today, okay? What you'll see if you're looking at the screen, you'll see here at the top this blue button. The reports that have the blue button next to them are custom reports. Those are a different kind of reports from your standard canned reports that came with QuickBooks Online. Now, you can still go to your standard reports, memorize them, and they'll pop up below without the blue button. So just to illustrate that point, I'm going to go ahead and go here, and I'm just picking a balance sheet. This is a sample company for those of you that don't know. And in order to save a report, so you're getting a little bit of a lesson here too, hey? You just want to hit this green button that says save customization. And I can do a reporting video separately, but if you wanted to change the filters and stuff, you do that here. But for today, we're just doing save customization. And this is going to be balance sheet test. And I'm just going to save it because I want you to see how this shows up. Okay. So I go back here, back to reports, go back to custom reports, and you see this balance sheet test item is what I just did. Note there is no blue button, okay? My blue buttons are up here at the top. Those are ones where I said create new report here in the top right, okay? And it says, do you want to start by report creation wizard or do you want to add data columns? And I'm just going to pick creation wizard. And you know what, we're just going to pick, I'm just going to pick something from the dropdown, but you can play around with this. You can't break anything. Just play around to your heart's content. Okay, so I created a custom report right here. I did it based off of my AP, and it looks a lot like a standard report, but you have some nifty little buttons up here. Okay, and I'm going to hit save. Okay, oops, and I have to put in a name. Silly me. AP report, so let's hit save, ta-da! Okay, silly me AP report has been saved. Now, you can see here, you can see your table view, and you can see here, you can do a chart view. This chart view and being able to toggle between the table and the chart is brand new. This is a new feature. So when I pull up my AP report and I hit chart view, I can do it here as a vertical bar graph. I'll give you a moment to check that out. Okay, so we've got the dates at the bottom on our x-axis. We've got the amount on the y. And then I can even change it to a trend line report with the same thing. We've got our time on the x-axis and our amount on the y. Okay, if you have questions about how this report was built, or if you have questions about reporting in general with QuickBooks Online, feel free to reach out to me. I love to talk to people. So, but with that all being said, I'm just going to go ahead and hit save. Okay. And that is now saved. Okay. So let's go ahead and go back to reports. Okay. Now, if I go back and I click in on this, let's see, where were we? Perfect. That's good. That's good. Perfect. Okay. You can see also up here for me, remember what I said about it rolls stuff out in stages? Okay, so for me, it still says schedule reports in beta. That's not actually in beta anymore. It's now live. So I'm gonna click the beta button. You should actually see a different icon here. So hit schedule report. And then we're going to hit schedule report test. Okay, and this is what we call a workflow. I've done another workflow video in my original QuickBooks Online demo, but workflows are kind of like a trigger and an action, right? So if you do this, then this happens. And there's several different kinds of workflows you can do in QuickBooks Online. This is just one unique one. Now, and those for you, so those of you that are asking, well, I remember I can schedule reports before. You could, but you couldn't schedule custom reports. Remember how we did the thing with the standard reports? And I showed you the standard one, didn't have the blue button. Brrr, time machine. So those you could schedule before, but with the custom reports, you now can schedule these as well. So I'm going to say, I want you to create and send a recurring report on November 17th every 1 week. And I'm going to have it send a company email to, and I'm sending this to my dummy account. So, all right. Hello. Okay. And then I'm actually, you know what? Yep, that works. Test. So if you have things like any kind of metrics, for AR, AP, you have different people you need to send some of this information out to. And if they want to see things visually, because I know a lot of us love looking at it visually versus, you know, tabular, then this is a great feature. And I'm going to hit save and enable. And we're good to go. Again, to specify, if you don't see schedule report here, you're going to see the icon, and maybe you're luckier than me and you get the icon faster. For me, I'm still waiting on the icon, but I can still do the same thing. I've got my schedule report. Both scheduling of custom reports, and this is important, so wake up, and creating graphs and charts are only available in QuickBooks Online Advanced. So just keep that in mind. And you actually call these flexi widgets, if that, and you'll probably hear me refer to them as such in the future. Okay, those are two of our new features. We have some others to go through. The quickest one, I'm going to go ahead and jump over into our QuickBooks Commerce. So I'm sure that you've heard of QuickBooks Commerce. You can hook up your different sales channels to your QuickBooks software, QuickBooks Online software, so you can kind of see that activity. Now, in order to get there, you're going to go down here to this Commerce button in my left toolbar. And then I've not connected this yet, but I'm going to connect my Shopify. Cross your fingers. I personally, side note, hate doing these live connections while I'm on video, because if it goofs up, then you watch me clicking all over the place. So then it's going to say, let's connect your Shopify account. We're going to bring in your data going back to here. Here's a quick spoiler alert. I don't actually have any data in there yet. I just did this today, Katie's. I'm going to pause the recording real quick while I pull my. Okay, guys, we're live again. I found it. Katie demo, do not touch. So you could tell I was trying to make sure I knew which one was Katie's. So here we go. I'm going to go ahead and sign in with my Gmail account. I set myself up as a user. Let's see. Okay, guys, I had to blank it out for a second while I logged in, but we have, it's now asking me, do you want to install this? I went ahead and signed in with my store information, okay? And I want to show this to you. So saying Katie's demo, do not touch. And we want to go through our privacy details real quick. Scroll down, custom storefront permissions and customer data. And this is all just saying this so that it can bring in relevant information for your QuickBooks Online. Now I hit go. Ah, it said connection completed. Shopify is connected. So we want to go to where does Shopify deposit my funds? We'll just pick the checking account. How do you want to pay Shopify fees? And we'll pick the checking account. Okay. And I want to make sure, yeah, it's a bank or credit card. This is not where do you want your expenses for your merchant fees to come out of. This is what account do you want your Shopify fees to be taken out of? Here we go. And this is just a mapping thing. So it's trying to make sure that it has everything mapped correctly. See, mapping Shopify payouts. We're bringing in data. We're setting up your sales overview. Great. Let's hit next. And then we added new accounts in your books to track Shopify. And Shopify is ready. Let's go. And you can see you can also connect another channel as well. So now I have a second homepage, y'all, where we have our QuickBooks Commerce information here. Okay. This is a newer feature to QuickBooks Online Advanced, but here's something you're going to love. QuickBooks Commerce is also available in Plus. I think it's available in Essentials, but I'm not for sure. So if you have any questions about that, please let me know. Okay. We just showed you the linking of your e-commerce accounts. And what all and you can see right here, we've got our channel connections right here. And if we want to connect another sales channel, we can also do Amazon and eBay. Let's see, scroll down. But yeah, you've got a ton of information. You can see all your orders as they come in. You can see your payouts. For those of us from the old days where you're having to take deposits in, like your batch deposits and net out your fees and the rest of it, like the old school way, this is going to be a lifesaver. Okay, so that right there was your e-commerce accounts. Now let's step over to the next one we're going to go over. We're going to go over recommended sales tax categories. In order to get to the sales tax categories, you have to have your sales tax set up, okay? If you're not sure where your sales tax section is, it's down here in your left-hand navigation. You go to taxes and sales tax. I've already set this one up. If you want more information on the sales tax module, I have a video for that. So check the channel and you'll see it. I'll also try to post it in the description if I remember. So we hit sales tax settings. So you've got your economic nexus. I'm not going over all that today because I went through it on the other video, but you want to have your sales tax set up. Then what you want to do is you want to make sure that, okay, so we've got our sales tax set up. One moment, guys, I'm getting my brain righted. Okay, so we want to go in products and services. Now, with the sales tax recommendation, it uses machine learning and it's going to say, hey, you're setting up this item. It kind of sounds like it might be this, and that sounds like this type of sales tax item. For those of you that are familiar with sales tax, you know that sales tax applies different rates to different kinds of services and products and the rest of it. Most services, you know, in certain states may not even be taxable. For specifics on your situation, make sure you talk to your accountant. But for today, we're going to go ahead and demo this out. I'm going to hit non-inventory. And a non-inventory product is a product that's in my QuickBooks that I do not track inventory for. It's the same term as you'll see in QuickBooks Desktop. I'm going to put clothing. I want to see what my machine learning comes up with, if it's going to go kapow and make me just sit here and go, whoa, look how technology has moved on. Okay, so check this out, right? So we put clothing, and you see this little widget here? It looks like it's from the Jetsons. This item might have special tax considerations. Please select confirm to apply our suggestion. Here's a pro tip for QuickBooks Online users. Sometimes they make things a little bit easier looking than they are actually easy. Bank feeds in particular, sometimes they glitch and you get the weirdest linking. And if you're not paying attention, it'll bring in all these oddball transactions in a weird way. I've got one that's been happening to me for years. Every time I put in giftcards.com, it thinks it's cars.com. A gift card and a car are two totally different things. Again, wonders of technology, right? We still need humans to interpret the technology, and that's not going away anytime soon. But technology and machine learning, AI, it's really cool, okay? So if you look down here, it says sales tax. We think this is general clothing. Is this correct? And I'm going to hit confirm. Okay, if I was concerned about it, I could go in and change it manually. Now it's mapped. Keep in mind, it's mapped this new item to this general clothing sales tax item. And now if the state that you're in where you have Nexus, if they update the rates for that sales tax, QuickBooks is going to keep that rate updated for you. Love modern life sometimes. So that's fantastic. We love that. I'm going to hit save and close. Okay. Perfect. So that was the recommended sales tax categories. That's also new. We have a couple more things to go through. I'm trying to keep this video under half an hour, so I'm going to go through it pretty quickly. The next thing that we have on our list is paying contractors. So for those of you that want a way to pay your contractors and keep your contractor stuff organized in QuickBooks Online, you're going to love this. I think currently, as of the recording of this video, it's about $15 a month, but they will pay your contractors with next day direct deposit. Tell me a contractor is not going to just love you for that and will probably subconsciously do a better job because they love people that pay them quickly. So you can pay your contractors from the payroll contractors piece there. You can also ask them for their W-9 information from within QuickBooks and more. And then you get automated 1099s at the end of the year too. So we all love payroll solutions and how they make our payroll easier. Now QuickBooks has this for contractors too. If I can call your attention over to the left-hand navigation, you go to the payroll button, and we go to contractors, okay? I don't think I have it set up in this one. Here we go. Oh, here we do. Okay. So this is going to have me, there you go. For $15 a month for your first 20 contractors, you can go ahead and get started with this. And this is a form of QuickBooks Online payroll. Now, so what it will do, it'll say, what was your last payment? If you paid it with a check, it will bring it in. It kind of cross tabs or cross references. I can speak. Your vendor's table. So it will pull up manual payments from before. And then if I had my direct deposit turned on, it would say pay with direct deposit. I put in my information, how much I wanted to pay. One tiny, itsy, bitsy, teeny, weeny little gripe. You can future date contractor payments, but you can't set them on repeat. So if you have the same amount that you pay a contractor every month, you do not yet have the ability to say, just pay this every month. But that being said, I know I would like that feature at first glance, but at the same time, if you forget that that's on, I mean, it could possibly hose you up. And I imagine they'll add that at some point. But what I do usually is I just go ahead and future date multiple payments. It will take that and it will deposit those payments per the schedule you indicated. Okay. So that was your paying of contractors. And at the end of the year, you can also do, this one says prepare 1099s. They will do your 1099s with you and stuff. Next, and this is our last one for today, my dears, so we've got getting tips. To turn on tips, go over to your gear, go to account and settings. And you want to make sure tips is turned on first, right? Baby steps. So we go to account settings, we go to sales, we go to sales form content, right? Accept tips. Yes, please. And I hit done. Okay. Once you do that, you'll have a tips section or a tips turned on in your sales receipts and in your invoices, sales receipts and invoices, which are both of your sales forms, really. So I'm going to go ahead and hit new, and I'm going to hit sales receipt. And because I don't feel like filling this out, I'm going to hit my little clock up at the top. For those of you that have done this before, you know what I'm doing here. I'm picking a recent one. If you hit that clock, it's saying rewind. It'll pick up a recent one. So then I picked receipt 207. I scroll down here to the bottom. You could put a tip in. Now, what they're adding is, and it's not out to mine yet, but is what they're adding is an ability to pick a percent that the person wants to pay you in tip, like 5, 10%, whatever. Again, if you don't see it yet, it's coming. It will roll out to you soon. With that all being said, I think that's everything for today, and I will make sure to get this in a blog post as well, and I'll go ahead and put any other links in there and everything. We are at 19 minutes, so we are well ahead of our 30-minute mark. Thank you so much for watching. Keep watching our channel. We have some great content coming your way. Thank you so much to our loyal subscribers, and I can't wait to talk to you again soon.